Jeff, have you heard of this new channel on YouTube?
Nope.
Guess what it's called?
We're going camping in the middle of winter. It's going to be 5 degrees and snowing.
No, the channel's called Candid Tourists.
Oh, right.
And if you're here, give us a like and a subscribe.
Right, okay.
And stick around because we are going to go camping in wintertime and we've got some other big news. So stay tuned. So this is us. We're at Port Arthur Holiday Park. And we got in about 5:30 yesterday afternoon, but in Tasmania at 5:30, heading toward the middle of winter, it is pitch black. It actually started to get dark about 4:45, so we knew we were actually going to pitch this thing in the dark. The good thing is that we are now the proud owners of an A-liner. It's a 2011 model, and it only takes about 30 seconds to pop up. So by the time you've done the clips, and you've hit the roof, sides are up, and we're done. And then we spent the rest of the night just going through and checking out all the bits and pieces to see what worked.
What's that?
I just wanted to add something.
Here he comes.
The van also has air conditioning and heating. And unfortunately that wasn't working until we realised you've actually got to turn the power on.
Yeah.
Knuckleheads.
Jeff was fiddling with all the buttons and looking at all the electrics. Yeah, and all he had to do was lift the panel underneath the seat and flick the on switch. So, well done, Jeff. So basically we packed our car up with all our usual camping gear minus the swag and our other few things, sleeping bags, and last night we pulled it all out of the car and we've done a bit of a resort this morning so that we can make the van work for us, get a little bit cozy in there. So we needed to find where we're going to put things so that we weren't climbing over or having to open too many cupboards on and off. So we've done that this morning, at least we've made a start this morning. We had to put the awning up. We are at Port Arthur.
Hey guys, we're about to try and put our awning on our brand new, well it's not brand new, it's second hand, but we've just picked it up last week. We've decided to go camping in five degrees.
So you get to see it come down.
Yeah.
You've got to put it down in order to put the awning on.
Yeah.
And I haven't done this before.
Yeah, so here we go. Two latches.
Good luck to me.
Latch and that one, done. Pull it towards you.
We've got these little cushion things here.
Yep.
So that doesn't impact on
damage.
The table.
Yep.
Alright.
Hold the door so it doesn't hit.
Actually, do you want to... Oh, we haven't got the thing there, that's alright.
Yeah, just pass over.
For a big drive.
Just pass over.
Hey?
Pass over.
What?
There's two there. It might be on the table.
One.
Yep, lift it up. Yep.
Alright, now the upper pump. That's your pump to try.
Now we're going to drop the roof down.
Close the little door. And then the roof goes.
Front one first.
Hey?
Front one first. Yep.
Yep, don't need a second hand over there.
Right.
Yep.
There you go.
That's it.
That's it.
Back to the one at the back. Pull that down.
Look at you. Go, girlfriend. Done.
Yeah.
We're ready to go home. Two locks. Goodbye.
We're set normally, up. You clip this one down and away you go.
Yeah.
But these little rails here, where the annex slides into, because this one's only smaller because there's some Velcro that hits bits in under here, and obviously it wouldn't shut properly if they had that going all the way.
All right, let's have a crack.
And then this one is the other side. So
let's have a crack.
This is the awning.
Yep.
I'm going to set up the other camera so we can film that one.
God, it's cold.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, it's a rough
section.
Yeah.
So you have to do this one first.
Yep.
So the awning edge itself has got a bit of cord that's sewn through and that gets slid through. Now you could do this yourself, but it'd probably take some time because you'd have to go from one end to the other to help guide it through. It's easier with two people, could be achieved with one, just take you a little bit longer. At the apex of the annex there is an eyelet and this clips onto a little post at the top of the AVAN itself. People have suggested that you leave this one vertical rather than horizontally attached and clipped in, just in case you have to get out at night time and remove the annex at all if it's very, very windy. We had ours clipped on. The annex itself is actually quite thick and durable. I can't see it flapping around too much in the ground, so long as you have your posts and spring pegs, you should be pretty right. The most annoying thing about putting the annex up is that you can have the annex in both rails on the A-van, but there is a Velcro piece, and as you lift the van up, it's very hard to push that last little bit down where it's connected with Velcro. We ended up finding a broom and just sort of rubbing it up and down the outside of the annex just to get the Velcro to stick. Otherwise we're going to need something to give us some height to get up there to do it ourselves, such as a stepladder. We were attaching our annex the following morning. We'd actually arrived the night before, and the reason for that was that it was dark and it was raining, and this gave us the light, and it was the first time we'd ever done it, so we wanted to make sure that we could see what we were doing and that it wasn't too wet. I had started the pole at one of the ends, and then I decided that the middle would be a better place to start. That way you could centre your annex properly and then work your way to the left and right poles. It took us about 10 minutes to get the annex up. So with some minor adjustments, we're now done. So this is the annex. It does have walls that came with it and a skirt that clips along the front of the A-van as well, so you can have a fully enclosed space outside of the van without having the draft coming back up underneath the van and into your space. So that's pretty cool. So you can see up under here, there's all the zippers ready to go to take those side panels. I think this is just another bit of a security one to make sure that it doesn't pop out of the railing, perhaps. Just to be on the safe side, we'll tie that up. So we needed this here today because there's that bit of Velcro as well at the top. It's a bit problematic trying to get that one down, isn't it?
Yeah, we should have stuck that before it went in. Right?
Well, I've got a broom in the toilet. We could probably bang it down somehow. I don't know. So this is an AVAN camper. It's the model 1D. And we've owned it for all of 5 days. It was really wet, so Jeff laid this down to stop a lot of the mud going into the van. Well, it probably wasn't the best choice because it actually wicked the water through. Tarp wouldn't have been much better, to be honest. 6 degrees last night, so Siri says, but we think it was much colder than that. And it's going to be raining on and off today. And Jeff is going to be cooking a roast in the weather, so we had to have the awning up because she can't have a Weber roast cooking in the rain.
Roast lamb and roast veggies.
So this is our little home away from home, and we're planning on doing lots of travels here. So we're Port Arthur this weekend, and hopefully getting maybe even coming back here in a little while, and thinking about taking a pilgrimage across to Bathurst at some point later in the year.
Yes.
So that's something to really look forward to. Now, we've opted for a powered site, and we did that because we're not quite sure how the solar electrics works, and we knew it was going to be a bit cloudy, so we're not going to get a lot of solar energy coming through that panel. But we picked an ensuite site here at Port Arthur, and they are fantastic. So if you've never seen an ensuite caravan space before, or camping space before, I'm about to show you. So here's our setup. The park itself has got beautiful grounds, lots of trees. And although you can't see it, although we're going to walk, there's water down in amongst there. We're way down there, so we'll go for a bit of a walk. But anyway, this is the ensuite. So there's only a few. I think there's only about 8 ensuite sites here. And this is going to be a bit messy, so sorry about this. But in your ensuite site, all right, you get your amenities, and there's a shower in there. And it comes with towels and soaps and those sorts of things. It's an extra $10 a night, so this is a terrific idea if you are testing out your camper for the first time and you're not quite sure how everything works. We do have a camp toilet, so that when we do finally get ourselves off grid, we'll be able to set that up and use that. And they've got a bit of a camping tent that goes in. So we're off. Are you ready to go for a walk? All right, so we're about to go for a walk and check out the grounds. So let's go and check out Port Arthur Caravan Park, or Holiday Park. Each of the campsites at this holiday park came with its own fire pit. You were able to purchase wood from the reception. It was $15 for each milk crate of wood. I suggest bringing your own kindling and wood and firelighters with you. The caravan park's quite empty at the moment. It wasn't like this last night. There was actually campers all around us. We're just staying on for the second night christening the van. And I'm sure that there's going to be a ton of people who turn up here again this evening, so we'll wait and see. The toilet and shower amenities were excellent and cleaned daily. And there was a huge laundry room for those who were staying longer than a few days. Big, big fireplace here. Sit around. Barbecue areas. A whole heap of them. It's a little skate park, is it?
I don't know.
I think it is. Yeah, that's a little skate park.
Oh,
for little kids. Yeah, it is. And they use their little, they use their bikes. That's really cute. There was also a huge kitchen and recreation room with an outdoor area that had its own pizza oven. You had to book all of this due to COVID restrictions, but plenty of space to go around. From this holiday park, there is a track that will take you on a short walk through to Stewart's Bay and then on to the Port Arthur convict site. Taking a little walk from our caravan park site, and this is the Isle of the Dead over there. So you travel to that. If you do Port Arthur, they take you for a cruise around there. And then just immediately over here, up in here, is Stewart's Bay Lodge, and there's a lovely little beach coming up. What a pity it isn't a sunny day.
Come on, what are we
doing?
We're going for a swim? It's about 4 degrees.
It is about 4 degrees now.
You go, I'll go in.
It's a terrible part of the country.
Country?
I can't believe.
We're not part of a country, we're our own state.
Terrible part of Tasmania. You should never come here. It's awful.
Yeah. We're our own country.
There's no one around.
You can see the helicopters coming over the island. There's trees there, straight from Mash, isn't it?
It is a bit. So quiet and peaceful, so glad. Except for the waves, they're making too much noise.
Waves.
I left Jeff alone, he's been setting up some stuff, getting some beers out. I can see the chairs. I've just been shopping for some and some wood being delivered. so we can have a bit of a fire pit. Probably not for long, so it's going to rain later. Smell the gas. You got it on already, warming up.
Yeah.
Nice work. All right, wood's on its way. What are we having for lunch?
I felt steak.
Mmm. You got a beer? Good to see.
I have.
Just learning how to cook. Using this little beast. So, a funny but a sad story. I named our van.
Funny but sad.
It's funny but sad. I've called, or I tried to surprise Jeff, and I've called it the... So I called it John James after Jeff's dad who passed earlier this year. And then he turns around and he says, you should have called it the John Jack.
Hello.
Because then it would have been both dads. But then I've named it James, which is his grandfather. So I really, really stuffed it. So I could either peel it off and make it John Jack, or I could leave it the John James. But anyway, I chose John because he was the one who used to do all the camping with him.
Yes.
And and we're going to camp on in his memory.
Did you say?
Going up market with our new little baby cue.
Good to go. 3 minutes.
Awesome.
Set time off.
3 minutes each side. And our firewood's turned up.
I've lost my phone.
Jeff only wanted me to get one, but I got two.
Hey Siri, set timer for 3.5 minutes.
Look at us being all technological.
Okay, your timer is set for 3 minutes and 30 seconds.
Well, I have a cricket machine at home and I got busy. As you saw before, we've officially named the van. Sweet moment, I thought so. And I've added a few more details to the back. Jeff's just rolling his eyes. He's not real happy at the moment, but I said they're not permanent, so they can actually peel off if he doesn't like them. But anyway, check them out. For obvious reasons.
Yeah.
And then I snuck this one on the back.
Yeah.
So it's got to be plugged in. So when I'm getting that, if you're in a powered site, you put that in your van.
So the site's down here at Port Arthur Caravan Park. They're drive-through sites. And what that means is that they'll have sort of main roads like this one I'm about to show you, okay? And you come down with your van or your camper and you find the number, such as this one, which is number 30, the one next to us. And you basically, you drive through. So down and into your site. And you can set up, there's pavers and things here so you can level out your caravan or your camper or whatever you're using. And you can push your car here. So obviously you still have a hitch to the car. Car's there. That's an ensuite. So this is an ensuite site that I'm showing you here right now. And then on the post, you have your electric, your water, and the pit full of grey water. So when you're driving through, you can actually drive out with your van. So there's no backing out. Having caravan parks set up like this is really, really useful because it means that you don't have to be trying to back your van in, which can be really quite difficult. This is what happens when you sell green wood to customers. Candid viewers, all I can say is bring your own firewood to the Port Arthur Caravan Holiday Park, because even with this many fire lighters, we haven't even been able to manage to get one piece of this wood to light. They've obviously sold us green wood, and I've only got this many left. Oops. So it looks like we're warming up under four highlighters for the rest of the evening. This log has been in for the duration of that whole packet. Still hasn't caught on. Look at it, what a waste. travelling around, you have to think about what sort of traveller you are, and we're the sort of people who like to have somewhere safe and comfortable to go and sleep and at night. But then during the day, we'll unhitch and take the car, and we usually travel around and visit places and want to see a bit of the place that we're in. So we're not kind of go to the destination, stay there for ages, and then just go back home again. We like to do the tripping around. So this will give us that option. Something small gives us a place to stay in overnight, but we still get to trip around and get the best of both worlds. But anyway, my eyes are watering. The wildlife are waiting for us to cook our dinner. I should probably go and get another beer. Probably spoken too much. I'll be back. I don't know what Jeff's cooking, but he's got an audience. Check this out. Just a few. One behind you, look out. Got another one. Here comes another one. Oh my goodness. Wow. You've got one under the car. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Unreal. We finally got the fire going and now the rain's setting in.
Ah, it's not sitting in.
And then it took us until dark.
It's not sitting in.
Jeff's in there singing his praises because he reckons he's cooked the best roast in history. He probably has. He's the sort of person who does that. He's got his little Bluetooth speaker with him. It hasn't left his side since this afternoon. And the contribution to the meal this evening is this little Weber. Because the couple that we bought the van off gave us a whole lot of extra little things that we probably wouldn't have had with the van, like hoses and tables and bits and pieces. And he's still going on about the roast, but you know what? Shh. It's Candid Tourist.
You wouldn't get a roast like that.
He talks about it all the time. Yeah. You can't give him. You wouldn't get a roast. You can't give him an inch.
No.
He takes a mile.
Guys,
just don't do it.
I'm going to tell you right now. This Weber Q is unbelievable.
Probably can't see you, Jeff, you're in the dark.
The Weber Q Junior, yeah. I cooked a steak today, big eye fillet, and it was fantastic. And now I've just cooked myself a leg of lamb and some roast vegetables. I've just sliced the leg of lamb after resting it for probably about 15 minutes, 10 minutes. My goodness, you wouldn't get that in your home. We've got a bloody smeg, big friggin' oven.
Yeah, but that, it's not about the ovens and stuff, is it? It's more about the cook. You know what? And I do all right in the smeg. Although I don't get as much accolade as what Jeff does because he's got a new friggin' Weber.
This is unbelievable.
I could have cooked 50 legs in the smeg.
This is unbelievable.
He cooks one roast in the Weber.
This is unbelievable.
Listen to him.
Oh!
All right.
This is unbelievable.
So there's the veg going out. That's the lamb.
This is unbelievable.
Getting played to, it's so important, it gets its own concert. it is so important, it gets its own damn concert.
Check this out. Oh, this is like pink.
It is good. Oh. Yeah, it smells pretty good. But I can't eat half, no, just give me a little bit.
Yeah, that's yours there.
All right.
This is mine.
Now, I haven't shown viewers inside the van yet.
Yeah,
we'll do that tomorrow, but this is a little bit of a sneak peek, so we got a little bit of a seating area for eating. Obviously fridge, cooking area, a little bit of storage here.
Oh,
and then over the back is the bed. And that's pretty much it. It's pretty simple,
I
isn't it, Jeff?
Help myself. It's what all we need.
It's all we need. It's simple, but it's all we need.
It's a comfy bed.
Yeah.
The fridge works well. The microwave, we said we'd never use a microwave.
No, but we have.
We've used it 2 days in a row.
So I have, So I have to let the viewers know that we are on a powered site. Now that has enabled us to use the microwave. We haven't worked out the hot water, but that's okay because we've managed to get some, but we've had the microwave. And this fan's really sport because it comes with its own little heat pump air. And we use the heat pump, and apparently I'm being summoned, so
I
gotta go.
Myself.
See you shortly. Yeah, spoon me some veg.
How good does this look?
Yeah, it's not too bad. Look at this. It's pretty damn good. We haven't gone like fresh stuff for the veg, though, like peas and carrots, but everything else is pretty cool. And we've got the bourbon. Thank you. Thank you, Cook.
Oh.
Looks good. Whoa. Mint sauce, tuck in. Here we go. Actually, I've got the, you got the mint sauce on?
Yeah.
We've got the special U-Butte fountain thick mint. It should be part of every single camping kit. Put it in your pantry. You're gonna need it. All right, that's a tip for the Candid tourists.
Look at this. Check this out.
All right, sit down, buddy. Let's have a meal. Cheers, cheers, cheers. Should we light the candle and make it really romantic?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Let's
bye.
Jig in.
That would be a lot easier without all the helping hands we've got.
Yeah.
You just had to shake out the canvas a little bit because obviously it's a bit wet and put it in the back of the car. But yeah, we had about five of these all come swooping down.
These birds were so tame that we actually saw some of them landing on other people in the park. And they were beautiful too. We had these beautiful little red-breasted wrens that were flying around. The holiday park has so many options for families and individuals to come and stay. We had a little bit more of a wander before it was time to hit the road and head back home. Look, we've hoped that you enjoyed our little bit of a camping weekend away at the holiday park. And we love that you are sticking around and watch our videos. Don't forget to give us a like and subscribe. And we'll catch you in our next one. See you then.